U.S. President Barack Obama announced an initiative Monday to enforce a federal mandate that requires states to give students of all ethnic and socioeconomic backgrounds equal access to quality teachers.
We want to make sure every child has that access to excellent teachers, and we're very confident that if we can lift up what works, that there are going to be a lot of states that want to adapt it.
The president made the announcement at a meeting of Secretary of Education Arne Duncan and a roundtable of teachers. The new initiative is called Excellent Educators for All. It's a long-ignored mandate of the No Child Left Behind Act. And joining us here to talk a little bit about this is Professor Terry Watson. She's an assistant professor in the Department of Leadership and Special Education at the City College of New York. Welcome back to Arise America. It's good to see you, Terry.
Thank you, Debbie. Thanks for having me.
Okay, so this is making a bit of a splash, but it's really a part of the No Child Left Behind Act that's been around all along. So much criticism of the No Child Left Behind. Is this an important part of this law to be focusing on now?
Indeed it is. And while similar language was included in the 2001 No Child Left Behind Act, it has yet to be acted upon, meaning that hopefully this initiative will really encourage states and districts to really try to find a way to make sure that highly effective teachers are in urban classrooms and communities.
Let's take a step back and just give us an idea, Terry, of how students, these high-need students, if you will, in these high-risk areas, how they are put at a disadvantage to continuously be put before teachers that either aren't, that are underperforming or aren't qualified to teach these subjects. What does it do to those students and their education?
Well, historically, poor performing schools were found in poor performing districts and communities, meaning that if schools performed well, they usually had, I guess, first choice at best teachers. Teachers are placed oftentimes by districts, and with tenure in effect in many states, though, many teachers would simply elect not to go to a poor-performing school. They would opt to go to a school that secured more or, I guess, better student outcomes. And oftentimes, that would disadvantage historically marginalized schools and communities. So hopefully, this initiative won't just put money at the issue, per se, but it'll really encourage teachers and districts, moreover, to really look at how we place students, or place students at a greater disadvantage by further by trying to find a nice way to put it. Well, we have to be more mindful about who we place in front of our children and really make a systemic effort to be mindful and make meaningful plans to not just say do it for a year or two, but how can we keep them in for 3 to 5 years, 7 to 10 years? Because not just teacher turnover is disadvantaging urban schools and communities, poor student outcomes are further redlining these children.
So you still found a nice way to say that.
Thank you.
This initiative really has three parts. Take us through it. How does it work?
Right. Well, the very first part calls for schools, or rather for states, to have a plan by April of 2015 to have an education equity plan to really show the federal government what they're doing to place highly effective teachers in schools that have been historically marginalized.
So, you know what, as I was reading the information, and you posed a question in the conversation with our producer, and you said the question that really needs to be asked is, how do we get better teachers in these high-need schools? So I want to just ask you that question. How do we go about doing that?
Well, we have to really have, I guess, begin with the end in mind, meaning going to schools of education and really talking to students who are hoping to become teachers and telling them just what's needed in these schools so that there is a will, meaning they want to be there and know that while the realities they face may be a bit dim, the opportunity for growth and student success is still there, and we want them there, meaning we need them in urban schools and communities because teachers matter. Teachers are the most teachers really determine in a big way student success. Parents do matter, leadership matters, but teachers are the primary determinants of student success.
I really do
believe,
so we really
have to be mindful of who we place in front of them.
Teachers
and we want
the
teachers
backbone.
To want to be there.
Absolutely. They're the backbone of the community. Quickly, let me just ask you this. Then how do we define a better teacher, an excellent teacher? Because that's the crux of this.
And that's just it. Not only should we look at strong student outcomes in terms of data and standardized testing, but we want to look at effectiveness with an A, meaning who's providing the emotional support, the soft skills needed to help students become successful. So I think when we look for excellent teachers, we should be very critical of just what is excellent. Yes, we want strong data outcomes, but we also want teachers who have great rapport with students, teachers who are effective with an A, that are caring, that really take seriously the need to act in loco parentis, meaning in the place of the parents.
Yeah, and test scores can't be the only parameter.
Exactly,
for that.
Not at all.
All right, we'll have to stop right there. Terry Watson, thank you so much.
Thank you for
Good
having
to see
me.
You. You're watching Arise America.